coming up on Let's Go Adventure.
We take a look into the Trading Post gift shop before heading down to Disneyland, getting out of the heat in some aircon rides, trying some amazing foods, and seeing other attractions.
So pack your bags and let's go.
In the lobby we have the Trading Post, which personally I feel has a better merchandise shop than Disneyland Hotel. Generic plushes. 160 for a plush. You got the Pandora things, which is what Disneyland Hotel had as well, but it's pretty cool. I don't know why she's white. She's not a white color. The one thing that this place has that Disneyland Hotel doesn't is hotel specific things. So this is $150 for this coffee flask thing, $120 for this mug, the Explorer's Lodge. I'll be purchasing that. Got X stock or clearance stock. Oh, there's a little $200 for the stocking. But then the one cool thing that we are happy about is that they also have Disney 100 merch. And I have the exact things that we want. They did have the exact thing, so we do want that. But they must be sold out of the sign.
Gosh. Oh, this is why we gotta grab things when we see them.
Oh. 2 hours later.
Tell you what, it is a crisp 30 degrees today. Humidity is like at 86 or something, and Hong Kong Disney is bopping. It's been a great start to the day. Got myself a hat. We can see photo pass people, which we didn't see 2 days ago because of the rain, but they're out and about. So should be a good day today. When staying at a Disneyland hotel, you do get little coupon things and you do get a free gift at the parks. But make sure you ask what the gift is before handing in your coupon thing, because we got that. At Adventureland, she showed us what the gift was before taking our card and explained that there were others elsewhere. Here on Main Street, they just took our card, scanned it, and then gave us that and said, nope, that's all you get. So always ask what is available before actually taking it. We're here at Main Street Bakery just to get some brunch. I am going to get the Mickey ring as well as a Tarbo milk with pearl, and Emily's going to get herself a
Elsa hazelnut croissant.
Can you drink?
No, not right now.
So we finally found a place in the shade to sit. Emily's got herself the Elsa croissant, and she's going to have a bit of a whirl of it.
Very yummy.
What's it?
Like a croissant with vanilla icing, marshmallows, and Nutella.
Very nice. And what about your almond coffee?
Good coffee.
I got myself the Tarbo milk. I don't know what it is. I don't know what's in it, but we'll have a taste. Personally, I'm not a fan. It's just really flavored milk. It's like sweet flavored milk. I mean, it's nice because it's hot. It's a hot day, so it's cold, so that's good. So this is the Mickey ring. I'll rip it apart just to show you what's inside, because I don't know what's on the inside, so. Okay, it's just a donut on the inside. And now my hands are all sticky and full of chocolate. But the deal is, you always start with the ear, so. Probably that.
Is it?
Yeah. That is a nice, soft donut. Very good. Perfect. Personally, I feel but there's not much here that's good for a really humid day. Like the donut I had, amazing donut, melted basically as soon as I took it out of the packaging. But right now we're about to head into PhilharMagic simply because it's an aircon room and it's pretty much starting now, so we're just walking straight in. So it was just yesterday that I was saying to Em, I don't know how this park actually runs because, you know, there's not much attendance, it's not that big. But then I just realized schmucks like us who just go crazy because everything is so cheap, and Emma's going to explain why everything's so cheap.
Well, I've always wanted these lounge fly bags. I just got a wallet and a backpack. Both were 50% off, so it was less than 100 Australian dollars for both of them.
Exactly right.
And every merchandise store seems to have a section that's like 50 to 70% off. So if you find that section, so good.
Yeah, definitely, yeah. Find that section that's on the sale and then just dig into it, because that bag that Emily got was behind three not so good bags.
And it was the last one.
And it was the last one as well, yeah. So make sure if you do find that, dig straight in there, get messy, and get yourself a good bargain. Comment below if you know what these toys are called, because for life of me, I can't remember. We're gonna head on RC Racer. Says it's about a 30 minute wait. It is 10 to 1. So we shall see if it is a half an hour wait. Then we might get some lunch afterwards, I reckon. Now we were going to go on this yesterday, but it was pretty backed up, so we decided not to. Looks fairly similar. That's all right. So that was only a 20 minute wait instead of 30. And we got front row seat. So winner. So RC Racer is an absolute must-do here at Disneyland Hong Kong. The gut feeling of free-falling, amazing.
It was really cool. I wasn't so sure about it because it just goes back and forth, and from the ground it didn't look that spectacular, but it was really thrilling. It might be my favourite ride that we've done. Your stomach really does drop on the way back down. It's really cool.
Yeah, pretty simple, but pretty cool. Yeah. So yeah, definitely have to try that. Now we're heading off to Mystic Manor again, just because again, it's an aircon ride, it's inside, and it's actually a really cool ride to go on. So, oh, even the shade right now. Oh, it's nice. But yeah, oh, aircon. Yeah, now we're heading to Mystic Manor, and it's gonna be fun. There it is there, Mystic Manor. So Mystic Manor is only a 15 minute wait.
So long.
Time is currently 1:25, so we'll see if it's accurate.
I am Lord Henry Mystic. The young fellow at my side is Albert, my travelling companion, confidant, and rather mischievous founder. Yes, Albert, that's you. For several years now, Albert and I have travelled the world in search of rare and precious artifacts for you to enjoy as you tour our home in Mystic Manor. Legend has it that this charming music box has the power to bring inanimate objects to life with a touch of its enchanting music. Superstition and nonsense.
Alrighty, here comes our track now, and that only took about 20 minutes. So, almost on point.
Looking for... Oh, there's the music box I told you about. I must find my little friend.
So Mystic Manor, definitely one you've got to go on. We went on a different track this time, so we saw a couple of different things, so that's pretty cool. It's not all just the one track, but yeah, still absolutely amazing. Good spin on Haunted Mansion, love the story and everything, so yeah, pretty good.
It was really cool. I liked it even more this time, and we got to sit on the front, which does make a difference. I wasn't sure it would. It's only two rows, but it did. And I like that it's different each time. It makes me want to do it a third time.
Mm. And talk about the tracks.
Oh, it's trackless, we noticed the other day, which I think, other than Rise of the Resistance, is our first trackless ride.
Was Rise of the Resistance?
Trackless.
It was too. I think we're going to head off and get some lunch now. And yeah.
We came to the Main Street Corner Cafe for lunch today. We're both ordering off the set menu. So I'm going to have pan-fried plant-based crab cake, plant-based fish burger, and then seasonal fruit platter. And Connor is going to get the Caesar salad, the stewed seafood rice, and the Main Street Delight. My understanding is it's a combo deal, so that we pay each $288 for our meals, and it includes everything I just read.
So this is the Caesar salad. Three shrimp, croissant, and some leaf.
Is it a Mickey croissant?
It's a Mickey croissant.
This is the plant-based crab cake. Oh, there's two.
Here's it.
Yum. Wow. Like, it kind of tastes like a kind of chicken nugget, but slightly unusual, but in a good way. Yummy.
First opinion on the presentation of both meals. 10 out of 10.
Mine is a Mickey.
Mine is a... From an angle, mine is a Mickey somewhere.
Good fry.
It's one of those super how do you bite burgers.
Wow, yum.
Mine's basically just a seafood risotto thing. Oh, they're nice. This again would have been good if it was raining outside. It was just nice and warmy.
If only we'd crossed the street on that rainy day.
That's very nice.
A cantaloupe, watermelon, blueberry, strawberries, and pineapple.
Well, truth be told, I don't know what any of this stuff is. I accept strawberries. So we get a bit of this, a bit of this. Oh, that's hard.
Oh, I thought that was like icing.
So did I. Oh, jeez. Well, that's what's inside of it.
Oh, wow.
I don't know what that is. Oh, my lord. Oh. I still don't know what it is. Tastes right, though. Yeah.
Is it sweet?
Not really. I think that's chocolate.
Oh.
And it's chocolate. I don't know what that is. That's like some kind of like shortbread type thing. What's this egg? I'd say the egg's probably marshmallow. Or not. I don't know what it is. Not bad, Joe. Not bad. Alrighty, so I got myself a Mickey mud cake. Mud cake? No, a Mickey chocolate cake with some whipped cream and icing on top. I presume that's just going to taste exactly how it you would think it would taste. Oh, for God's sake. Look, it's not easy to... There we go. That is a nice, moist chocolate cake. That's very good. So now that it's getting a bit darker and a bit cooler, we're going to be jumping on to Space Orbiter. Alrighty. Number 9. Oh, I guess we've got to go one person each. Oh, bugger me. Alrighty, Emily. My... life is in your hands. Well, up we go. Personally, I feel like that Starship Orbiter, I didn't like it as much because in Disneyland, it goes higher.
Yeah, in Disney World, it goes even higher.
Yeah, it didn't go that high at all. And also, it was giving me the what's it called, the spaceships themselves were giving me Jetson vibes instead of actual rockets. I don't know, I just prefer the rocket look instead of the UFO type thing. But yeah. It was alright.
I like them. I think this is such a beautiful time of day to ride that kind of ride as well, because you can see all the lights coming on in the park. And it's a nice cool ride when the sun's not bearing down.
Look at all these rookies not knowing that people are just going to rock up 2 minutes before the light show starts and stand in front of them. But have a look at the castle.